For now, Verizon has not announced 5G plans for Tucson. But in August, some providers brought 5G to parts of Phoenix, making it one of a few dozen cities nationwide with service. We learned more about 5G's significance and its potential impact from Ravi Tandon, an assistant professor in the U of A College of Engineering.
Tell me, 5G, a lot of us are thinking about 4G. What makes them so different?
So wireless systems usually evolve in generations. And we started from the first generation to the second to the third. And currently, we are in the fourth generation of wireless networks. The fifth generation wireless networks, they will differ from the fourth generation in a bunch of different ways. The very first one being of higher data rates. So 4G phones usually give us sort of peak speeds of 50 megabits per second. And the goal of 5G networks is to increase the data rate by up to 10 to 100 times. So imagine downloading a movie on a 4G phone, a two-hour movie, it'll take you about 30 minutes or so to download a two-hour movie. In contrast, if you use a peak speed of a 5G network, you can download in a few seconds. So that's number one, which is high data rates. In other ways, such as low latency, 5G is supposed to have very low latency in transmission of data, as well as high reliability, so very few dropped calls and so on and so forth in 5G. In addition to these three aspects, another interesting thing in 5G is that of massive connectivity. So if you think about dense urban scenarios, let's say in New York City, if you look at 1 square kilometer of area, 4G can support, let's say, 50,000 devices. But on the other hand, 5G should be able to support 10 times more.
Businesses, municipalities, how are they adapting to all this? They also want it for the same reason.
Of course. So I'll give you a few examples. So for instance, one application or use case of 5G is that of smart cities and smart homes. And what people are envisioning is that if you take a city, for instance, we have traffic lights, we have different type of sensors on bridges and infrastructure. The goal is that with this massive connectivity enabled by 5G, all these devices and sensors will be interconnected to each other, and they might be able to make autonomous decisions. So for instance, if a sensor is installed on a bridge and a bridge needs a repair, then automatically somebody will be alerted. The person or the agency responsible for updating and maintaining the infrastructure can be alerted in real time that, look, there is this particular device or object that needs to be replaced and needs attention. Another set of interesting use cases are in automobile industry. So if you think about autonomous vehicles will need to talk to each other to adapt and make driving safer by adapting to the sort of their neighborhood environment on the road and so on. And this also requires very low latency communication and high data rates. So 4G, for instance, cannot enable autonomous driving. On the other hand, 5G will be one of the key players in enabling autonomous vehicles.
How expensive is this going to be? As a consumer, would I need to buy a new phone or new equipment?
I believe so. And the reason for that is the way 5G networks operate is completely different from the way 4G networks operate. The way our phones operate, they transmit signals over the air at certain frequencies. And it turns out that our current phones are not tuned or designed to work at those new frequencies that the 5G is envisioning to work on. So to that end, we will need to devise and actually buy new hardware, as you said.
What are some of the challenges with going to 5G?
So these frequencies, they provide us a lot of bandwidth. They provide a lot of spectrum, which means we essentially we can get higher data rates. However, these frequencies are very challenging to work on because as you go higher in the frequency spectrum, the signal decays very fast with distance. So 4G signals can propagate up to a few kilometers, whereas 5G signals will propagate up to maybe 500 meters, which means we will need to put in more cell towers. So that's one of the technical challenges, is to deploy more number of base stations. So people give this, call this as small cells. So small cells and a large number of cells will need to be deployed.
Dare I ask, what is next?
So that's a great question. You know, as I told you, the wireless networks usually evolve in generations, and these generations typically last for a decade. So as you know, 4G sort of started to roll out in the beginning of this decade, and we are nearing the end of this decade. So as we enter 2020s, 5G will be beginning to roll out, and My guess is that at the end of next decade, we will be thinking about new applications, which will be enabled by perhaps the next generation of wireless networks, say 6G and beyond.
Oh my goodness. Okay, Dr. Tandon, we'll have you back in 10 years. We'll talk about that new wave.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Okay, thank you.